Hello, my name is Michiel Tomier. I am head of department of respiratory medicine in Ziekenhuizen Limburg. That is an hospital, a 900 bed hospital that is located in the east part of Belgium. And I want to talk to you about lung ultrasound and COVID-19 pneumonia. We are now at the end of the epidemic in our region. It was something totally different 3 weeks ago. I have nothing to disclose. So that is the overview of my presentation. First is, and I think it's important, is understanding lung ultrasound and understanding the images. And then I want to talk about B-line and interstitial syndrome, the typical findings you see on lung ultrasound in COVID-19 pneumonia. And what do we know scientifically about the use of lung ultrasound and COVID-19 pneumonia? So on this chapter, I will talk about understanding lung ultrasound, two topics, physics and the pathological lung and ultrasound findings. Physics are important because you have to understand what the images mean. And as you know, air and ultrasound are not too good friends. So air doesn't, no, ultrasound or sound doesn't pass through air. It's like concrete. But it becomes interesting when within the air fluid is present and you will see changes in images. You have the physics and the interaction between air and ultrasound. You see here in this image, the probe from the ultrasound, and then the lung, a lung filled with air. And here, start of the lung, you have the pleura. What happens here is that ultrasound, sound, goes through the probe, but is mirrored back because of the presence of air. And this gives you this M image. So the image is constructed by your lung ultrasound machine. So what you see here is an artifact that you don't see lung. You see a sort of mirror and the information that goes back to your ultrasound probe. It becomes interesting when there is fluid in the air. Here you see in the diagram when there is only 100% air, and here a situation where there's 100% fluid. For example, pleural effusion gives real images because of the presence of fluid. When you have air, you only see an artifact, a constructed image by your lung ultrasound machine. It becomes interesting when there is more fluid than air present, and the lung ultrasound machine will construct you other images, partly also artifacts, we call that B-lines, or real images. So what type of images you can find on lung ultrasound? Well, four types: E-lines, air; B-lines, when there is more fluid than air, or when the lung becomes more dense. And you can have real images like consolidation and effusion. There are no other types of images you can see on your lung ultrasound. These four ingredients are present. So remember, we have four ingredients: E-lines, B-lines, consolidation, infusion. It's like flour, tomato sauce, mozzarella, and butter. And don't forget the salt, and the salt is the pleural line. So when you combine these four ingredients, you can have different dishes. Bruschetta, focaccia. This is not a pizza, it's very important. Italian friend told to me, it's not the same. and you can have something very difficult, and that's a lasagna. It's the same with lung ultrasound. When you combine E lines, B lines, consolidation, or infusion, depending on the focal or diffuse presence, monolateral or bilateral, you can have different diagnoses. And I invite you to read this article, a very beautiful article that explains that with these ingredients, you can have different diagnoses. So let me put an example of a lasagna on lung ultrasound. So you have your different images. What do you see here? Well, you see here the diaphragm, real image with the liver. What do you see here? Pleural fluid, real image. What do you see here? The pleural line and a B line that goes through your image. And what do you see here is a consolidation, a real image. And here, the same, it's a consolidation, and it is a tumor on the diaphragm. This patient had a mesothelioma. So I do a short recap. Physics, very important. Interaction between air and ultrasound. Sound don't go through air. So you get a constructed image on your ultrasound machine. You don't see lung. You see a constructed image of E lines. It becomes interesting when in the air there is more fluid and you can have different images. You can have artifacts like B lines, but you can have also a consolidation or fluid. You have four different ingredients. With these four ingredients, you can have different dishes. That's in ultrasound also. Okay, let me talk about the typical pattern, what you see on COVID-19 pneumonia. We will talk about the definition of a B-line, and we will also talk about the definition of interstitial syndrome. That is what we're going to talk about. But first is very important, is the machine settings. Well, we want to view artifacts. That means that we take a probe with a setting with no filters. Because in most of the probe, the machine will construct images so you can understand it better. But in lung, we don't need filters because we really want to view artifacts. And so in the MindRay TE7, I normally use the convex probe, the 5 MHz convex probe, and I set on lung setting. And there's a simple setting. It's a setting without any filter. I just give you an example of the filter setting. Here I use the convex probe without any filter, and here I use the abdominal probe, the 3.5 MHz, with a setting for abdominal, where you have a filter to adapt your image. It's on the same region, and here you see the pleural line with the B lines that go through your image. And here on the same region, you see you get a totally different image. And we know that to diagnose B lines, it's better to set the probe on without filter. What does B line mean, or interstitial syndrome? That is any pathological process that results in thickening of the interlobular septa. Means that when there is a thickening of the interlobular septa, there is an increase in lung density. And density, it's simple, means or there is an increase in mass, or there is a decrease in volume. When you have an increase in mass, for example, you can have it in fluid, scarring, like in lung fibrosis, and inflammation, like you see in COVID-19 pneumonia. But on the other side, you can also have a decrease in volume. You can have that in atelectasis, or in the context of a compressed lung by, for example, the presence of pleural fluid where the lung is compressed, you will have also an increase in lung density and you will view on your ultrasound the presence of a beeline. So what is a beeline? It's a comet tail laser-like artifact. It's an artifact, constructed image from your lung ultrasound machine. It arises from the pleural line. See here the pleural line. It's hyperechoic and does not fade and erases the beelines. So what you see is a line. It moves with the lung sliding and it goes through your image and you don't see any E lines anymore. That's the definition of a beeline. Sometimes you have little laser-like lines. We call that Z lines, but that is really not the same than a beeline. Beelines must go through your image. Do we have different types of beelines? Well, the first is what is interstitial syndrome? That's the presence of three beelines in the single field. And when you have that in different fields, we call that core-focused interstitial syndrome, or in an interstitial syndrome to cool. You have an example of a patient with fibrosis, and there you see a lung fibrosis, a thickening of the pleura, and the different beelines. And while there was a lot of research on that, the space between the beelines is about 7 millimeters. That is just the space of the interlobular septa. But I find this very difficult. Here you see an example of pulmonary edema. There you see that the pleural line is less thickened, but when you see the space between the beelines is less than 3 millimeters. So I do a short recap. So the key points: interstitial syndrome, it's a pathological process that results in the thickening of the interlobular septa, generating at least 3 beelines in a single field on the view on echo. The beeline erases from the pleural line and erases the E lines. It don't fade, it goes through your image. What does beeline or interstitial syndrome mean? It means an increase in density. An increase in density can be or you increase your mass or you decrease your volume. So in function of the pathology, you have to interpret the image. So can we use lung ultrasound in the diagnosis of COVID pneumonia? Well, it depends on your question. And it depends also on the context where you work. The screening setting is different from country to country. For example, in our hospital, the patient with possible COVID-19 pneumonia had first a swab. We had a waiting time for maximum 6 hours to have the result of the swab. And if the swab was negative and the clinic was very suggestive, then we did a CT scan and the second swab. But I know, for example, in a hospital in the Netherlands, they had to wait 24 to 84 hours for the first result of the swab, and they performed a CT scan. And as you know, the CT scan is very sensitive for COVID-19 pneumonia, but the specificity is very low, between 15 and 25%. But as you know, CT scan is not always available in all emergency departments, and the question is, can we use lung ultrasound in these settings? The first thing is, does lung ultrasound can make the diagnosis of COVID-19 pneumonia? Now, I did a research, and we don't find at this moment a lot of studies. I found a relatively good study from Lu from China, recently published, and they compared the CT scanning versus lung ultrasound. And they found a moderate agreement between CT scan and lung ultrasound with a Kappa score of 0.53. So a Kappa score is an agreement score between 0 and 1. 1 is a perfect agreement, and 0 between, if there is an agreement, the agreement is there by chance. Another, I think, interesting is the diagnostic accuracy of lung ultrasound compared with CT scan. And there they found that if there is mild disease on CT scan versus severe disease on CT scan, you have another diagnostic accuracy for lung ultrasound, 77% for mild and 93% for severe affection of the lung on CT scan. So what is the scientific current knowledge on the use of lung ultrasound in COVID-19 pneumonia? I think mostly is based on expert opinion. So my question is, can we use lung ultrasound as a screening tool? If you want to know this, you have to set up good studies. I think you need different questions. The first is, what is the positive predictive value? That means that if you see lesion or lung ultrasound, what is the predictive value that it would be COVID-19 pneumonia? But as you know, ultrasound is a very good tool which is sensitive but less specific. So I don't think it has a place to predict the positive value in COVID-19 pneumonia. What I think is interesting is to set up a study to calculate what the negative predictive value is of COVID-19 pneumonia. Means that when you see normal findings, you can exclude the presence of COVID pneumonia. Another interesting is the typical findings, what you see on COVID pneumonia is the interstitial syndrome, the presence of different B lines. Till now, there is no study that calculates the inter-observer viability. There is one study ongoing, and it's a study what we are performing now. And at least is a study cost effective? It depends on the context where you work, if you have a CT or not, and if you have a low resource setting. Here you see a photo from Luigi Pisani, an Italian friend of me, who is doing research in Bangladesh about malaria and pneumonia. He used lung ultrasound, and you see the other most technique they have is to do a chest X-ray with this method. So in this view, I think lung ultrasound will give me more information than this chest X-ray. I did a search in clinical trials, in clinicaltrials.gov. I assessed that on the 1st of May. And I found at that time 15 ongoing trials. There is one important trial. It's a trial that we are performing now. And it's a trial where we want to calculate what the inter-observer variability is in interstitial syndrome in patients with a diagnosis of COVID-19 pneumonia. So this is my last slide. Three key points is, first, you have to understand the images on lung ultrasound, and you know there are different ingredients, and with these different ingredients you can make different diagnoses. The second is the typical findings you see on COVID-19 pneumonia is interstitial syndrome. Interstitial syndrome, you have to know, is an increase in density, and density can be increased or by increase in mass or decrease in volume. And last is the current knowledge is based on expert opinion. If we really want to know how to use lung ultrasound in COVID-19 pneumonia, we have to perform studies. Thank you for listening. I want to invite the audience to become a member of the working group ultrasound of the European Respiratory Society. And second, if you have questions, you can always contact me by my LinkedIn account. Thank you very much.